Here is my hammock. I'm going to set it up and show you the details. Treehugger is a 1-inch piece of webbing that I sewed a loop in with a metal ring. So it goes around, comes through another sewn loop that I hook my carabiner in, then just a piece of rope goes to the two rings. I'll show you how I do that. Here's the hammock and my ridge line. And the same thing here. Here I have just an extra slip knot to be sure. And I'll show you how this works. So you have two rings. You go through once. And then you go through a second time, but halfway out. Once again. So you go through once, come under, and once again through. And this way you can pull to make it shorter. If you pull this way, it's stuck. If you want to loosen it, you have to open the rings and then you can adjust where needed. And to be sure, just an extra slip knot. Opa. And that's it. Here's my DD tarp 3x3 meters. So I started with a loop, went around the tree, went through it, and all the side to the other side of the tree. All the way to the other side, sorry. Went around, came back, pulled this tight, go back, this one. So it come back. And then this is hooked in a carabiner, simple one, that is attached to the ridgeline with a Prusik knot. Doesn't go anywhere if it's pulled tight. The DD tarp is over the ridgeline, also held in place by two Prusik knots, one here and one on the other side. And here I changed the usual guy lines with this elastic stuff, because if you would walk in the dark to a camp and you would walk accidentally in your guy line, with the elastic part is no problem, so I don't have to reset the tarp again. And with the carabiners I added a small piece of rope with a S carabiner, so if it's stuck in really deep it's very easy to just take the rope and pull it out again. It's quite useful, especially in the snow. So I got two extra carabiners and two extra normal guy lines, just in case there's strong wind, so I can also then, for example, pull it out here in the middle. Would it rain a lot, then I'll of course first set up the tarp and then the hammock. Water that comes from the tree or collects here will drip off of the carabiner, and if that doesn't work then it will drip off here at the two rings and then down the rope, the leftover part. I've never gotten wet in a hammock, so hopefully there won't be a first time as well. In the hammock I have usually a small bag. I made it from the same material as I made my hammock, with two pockets. In one I usually have my headlight. It's a Petzl with a red light option. In the other pocket my glasses or pocket knife or something, whatever. And in the winter months I have also a thermometer. Currently it's 0 degrees. And this is my usual setup. If it's really windy from front or back, I have the options to not use this corner but that one, and this I can fold back. I'll show you a picture of a previous trip. And same on the other side, so it's nice and closed. I hope you enjoyed it. Have a great day. Bye.